Hey everyone, Jason here. A few years ago, I posted a Lego computer keyboard I designed around an old membrane keyboard I had lying around. And ever since then, I've wanted to build a version using mechanical key switches for superior performance. And I finally got around to it only 3.5 years later. And this is the result. And let's just jump right in and show you how I built it. For the core components, I just pulled out the circuit board from this Cooler Master Quickfire, which has Cherry MX Brown key switches on it. I actually probably would have preferred blue, but you know, you get what you get. It's a little bit of an older model, as I just wanted something simple and relatively cheap. So it doesn't have full backlighting or anything fancy like that, although there are a few LED switches on it for the caps lock, scroll lock, and Windows lock keys. Here is the Lego frame I built to house it. It's extremely simple. It's just a layer of plates on the bottom, which are connected together with another layer of tiles that span the seams on the inside. The back and the sides are just built up using basic plates and bricks with some panel pieces on the sides to make it easier to lift the keyboard up and move it around. For the front, I'm using these curved slopes oriented on their ends just to give it a little bit more interesting profile, and they are connected to these brackets. This is the breakout board that has the USB connector on it. And I actually did sacrifice a few Lego tiles to mount it. I just screwed it right into them to give it a nice solid connection for connecting and disconnecting the USB cable. I also added a nice little arch in the back to give clearance for the cable. There are a couple of 1x1 cones in the base which line up with these holes in the circuit board, which just rests nice and snugly into the Lego frame. And here's the top part of the frame, which helps keep the board in place and also fills up some of the spaces between the keys. As you can see, I went with an old school Lego color scheme with red, yellow, and these blue, I guess, racing stripes to help me type faster. On to the most important part, which of course are the keys. And for that, I recruited my brother, who is a mechanical engineer, to design these Lego-compatible Cherry MX keycaps. Most of the ones I'm using on the keyboard are black. Actually, all of them are black. But I do have these white prototype ones, which might be a little bit easier to see. As you can see, they're pretty much the equivalent of a 2x2 Lego plate, which is conveniently about the same size as a standard keyboard key. And they have a Cherry MX stem underneath, so that you can easily add some small Lego pieces or tiles onto the top of them and just sit them right on the key switches. He also added a hole into each of them. So for the key switches that do have LEDs, you can put a transparent tile on top for the light to shine through. He uploaded the design of these to Shapeways, which is where I had them printed. And I'll add some links in the description and more details over on my website for anyone who might be interested in getting some for their own keyboard. He also designed some other sizes for me, all the way from 2x3 up to 2x14 studs for the special keys and the spacebar. And here's the keyboard with all the keys added. I reused a few of the tiles that I used from my original keyboard on this one. For example, I'm still using the baseball cap for the caps lock, the roof tile for the home key, the guy running away from the dinosaur for the escape key. But I did make some significant changes. For example, I decided to do away with the letter tiles entirely, since I don't look at the keyboard when I'm typing anyway. Instead, I made this small little mosaic, which spells the word Lego, which I thought was pretty appropriate. And I still have the jumper plates for the F and the H keys, so I can find them by touch. I also tried to do a little bit of color blocking based on functionality. So most of the navigation keys are yellow, for example, tab, backspace, enter, space, the arrow keys, and the page up, page down. Most of the control keys are white, including the escape key and the print screen, etc. over here. And pretty much everything else is mostly black. There are some exceptions, of course. Just like with my previous keyboard design, I limited myself to using printed tiles that have only been produced by Lego over the years, so no stickered tiles or custom prints. Of course, if I ever decide to change any of them or actually add the letter tiles for the letter keys, it'll be really easy to do. I just need to pop them off and replace them. And that is about all there is to it. As I said, I have been meaning to build this for quite a while, so I'm happy that it's finally finished. And it works a lot better than the original one I built, which incidentally I took apart about a year ago, which is why I don't have it out here for comparison. I may still tweak the frame a little bit, maybe try and make the design a little more interesting. But of course, the beauty of it all being designed out of Lego pieces is that will be really easy to change. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you next time.